Wisconsin's candidates for governor face each other in a live debate. Good evening, I'm Toya Washington.
And I'm Terry Sater in for Kathy. 12 News' Mike Gousha is here with our Commitment 2010 coverage. Mike?
Terry and Toya, recent polls show Democrat Tom Barrett trailing Republican Scott Walker in this race. Tonight at the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association debate in Milwaukee, Barrett went on the offensive, repeatedly criticizing Walker's record.
There's a record here, and Scott Walker's record is much different from mine. 2008, implosion of our economy, worst economic downturn since the Great Recession, he eliminated his Office of Economic Development. In the worst economic recession since the Great Depression, he eliminated his Office of Economic Growth. That'll tell you that it's not a priority. It's never been a priority for his. Now he's saying it's a priority. It simply is not.
Specifically, what I'll do as governor, and I mentioned this the other day in Green Bay when I first announced it, on the very first day I'm in office, I will declare an economic emergency and call on the legislature for a special session on jobs, a special session that will focus not only on jobs, but jobs with cuts and taxes for small businesses, making sure that we help them out with less litigation, less regulation, and with ultimately eliminating the state tax and health savings accounts. Those are the things in our first month in office we'll take on. We're not going to let the lawmakers go home until they get the job done.
On plans to spend $810 million on high-speed rail, Barrett said he supported it and went back on the attack. Walker, though, fired back.
I do support this project because I think it will help create construction jobs, and I think it will be good for economic growth throughout the state of Wisconsin. And I will ensure that we don't have cost overruns. Just as we had a major project at City Hall where there were no cost overruns, I'll make sure that happens from the onset. I think Scott would like to make this a defining issue in this campaign, and in a sense it is a defining issue, but for a different reason. And I'm going to go back to the straight talk. Scott Walker knows that this money can be used for one thing and one thing only, high-speed rail. He likes to pretend it can be used for other things, but he knows better. He knows it can't be used for other things. The honest question for him to answer is, do you want this money to be used for high-speed rail in Wisconsin? Or do you want it to be used for high-speed rail in Florida?
And I think when people look at it, and they're frustrated, not only with Madison, but they're frustrated with Washington, with the runaway government spending and how to control things are, they look at this project and say, again, according to the Obama administration, this will create 55 permanent jobs. That's more than $14.5 million per job. I think anyone out there looks out today and says, we could create a whole lot more than 55 permanent jobs with that kind of money out there. The bottom line is, I would much rather send that money back to Washington than be stuck with money that we can't afford, with a system we can't afford and don't want in this state. But the mayor's wrong on this. We've done this once before. In the 1990s, Tommy Thompson took $241 million that was designated for light rail in the East-West Corridor, went to the congressional members from Wisconsin and Washington, and got them to change that money so it could be spent on the Marquette interchange, changing ultimately replacing hundreds of millions of dollars of state taxpayer money that would have otherwise had to go into that project. We can if we have the right leadership. That's what we need in Madison. It's not Republican or Democrat, it's leadership.
If you saw tonight's debate, you probably noticed the format featured no rebuttals. So the candidates were not able to respond directly to some of the sharper comments directed their way. For example, Walker could only shake his head when Barrett said this.
Scott's mentioned Governor Doyle's name three times. Scott, Governor Doyle's not running. There are two of us on this stage right now. I'm the only one who ever ran against Governor Doyle. I ran against him 8 years ago, and I ran against him because I thought I could do a better job. You started running against him 4 years ago, but you dropped out. You dropped out because the party bosses told you to drop out of the race. I had the courage of my convictions. I had party bosses telling me to drop out. I had the courage of my convictions. You should have run against him 4 years ago, Scott. He's not running now.
Late in the debate, Walker also went on the offensive while Barrett had to stand by and watch.
As county executive, I made a pledge to hold the line on taxes. In fact, I've done it for 8 consecutive budgets. I'll do it again next Thursday. That's something I didn't just have an election year conversion on. Like the city of Milwaukee, where for 6 straight years they've raised the property tax levy. In fact, for the current year, taxes and fees went up $21 million. I didn't just decide to hold the line on taxes right before an election. But we've still been able to maintain core services. We've got a gold medal for the best park system in the country. We have one of the fastest growing airports in the United States. We've done all sorts of things while still balancing the budget without raising taxes.
This was the first of 3 debates between the candidates. And tonight you could see that each used a very different strategy. Barrett, clearly the aggressor. Walker, barely acknowledging Barrett's presence, sticking to the question. Toya and Terry.
All right, Mike, thank you. 12 News' Jason Newton was also at the debate tonight.
He continues our team coverage with the candidates' reactions to their very different styles.
They're frustrated with side by side, the two candidates for governor came prepared, both on message and one on attack.
I thought it was important for us to talk about the differences between the candidates.
The mayor spent a lot of his time attacking me. That's been consistent with his ad campaign.
This could all be the work of polling. Walker in the lead with a more passive approach.
I spent my time focusing on the questions and really listening to the panelists and viewing those as questions from the public.
Barrett out swinging from behind in the most recent polls.
I felt we're going to talk about our records. I think that's fair game, and I thought it was important for people to hear what our respective records are.
The format allowed for candidates to field questions, hot-button issues. Barrett matched with heat of his own, but the format did not allow either man a chance at rebuttal. Walker responded with, to answer your question, several times, not addressing the attacks.
It's a little tough because there's a number of times when you'd like to point out something that was wrong.
Now, that strategy continued afterwards, Walker taking only about three questions before heading out to his son's football game, sticking to his message the whole time. Barrett continued his attacks with his camp, even firing out four emails before the debate was even over. In the .com center, Jason Newton, WISN 12 News.
Thanks, Jason. The candidates for governor will face off again right here on WISN 12. Tom Barrett and Scott Walker will participate in the 12 News Town Hall Challenge, moderated by Mike Gousha. The statewide event takes place Friday, October 15th. Then 1 week later, the two candidates for U.S. Senate will join Mike for their own Town Hall Challenge. You can see that debate live on Friday, October 22nd, right here on WISN 12.